Oh, hey, everybody. Hey, it's me. Oh, yeah, check it out. I'm out of medicine, man. I gotta go pick up some medicine. Yeah. Okay, seatbelt, right. Mask. Okay, I got some green tea this morning. It's really good. Yeah. Okay, we're going for a drive. I'm gonna be real careful, and I'm gonna go nine. Car's driving good today, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna go 9-3 today. I believe 9-3 is the new 10-2, right? Okay, I'm going 9-3. Okay. Hi Birdie. Oh, keep hopping, Robin. Yeah, you're up early. You gotta get all those worms. Yeah. Okay, I'm clear. Okay, I'm gonna have to shut this. Oh, there's a squirrel in the road. Oh man. People write songs about that. Okay, I gotta go. I'll be back. Okay, bye. Oh, it's me again. It's a red light. Yeah. Oh, I remembered the sideways HD view here. Yeah. So you can see me in high def now. Okay. Here we go. It's green, but I feel pretty good about driving and talking here. Okay. Oh, I just saw a help wanted sign. It said get paid to make perfect snacks. I don't know what that means, but I like snacks, right? Yeah. There will be snacks. Andrew Burke promised us, man. Oh, wait, I gotta go. Okay, hang on. Oh, hey, it's me. Yeah, I'm off the highway. I can talk now for a couple minutes. Okay. Oh, did you see this clip of the Joe Scar dude? Right? He gave the business to Zuck and his partner. Oh, man, he was just yelling and ranting and raving. It was pretty good, but see, you know, I don't like those shows, especially his. It's just like, you know, it's like, you know, stopped clock, right? Twice, right? Something. And you know, so it was a good rant, but you know, I don't care about that dude, and he's just trying to protect his phony baloney media morning job, right? He's making bank doing all that crap, and you know, it's all about the advertising, man. They don't care about you. I mean, yeah, it's like what he said was right, but they don't give a crap about you watching. You're just your eyeballs, man. They're selling you crap. Yeah. Okay, I gotta get ready to put my mask on. I'm about ready to pick up my medicine here. Yeah. We're doing the curbside thing, man. Oh, it's so good. So good. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, see ya. Hey everybody, happy Pizza Wednesday. Yeah, I got a feeling that, you know, after my medicine run, I'll probably have the munchies later. Good day for some pizza. Oh, we got some awesome birthdays to celebrate today, right? Oh boy. John Abbey. Whoa. Old Town School veteran. Oh, it's like I know all of them. Not really. I met John about, I don't know if John even remembers this. I met John about 25 years ago. I think, what's that joint on Damon near Division? Is it called the Silver Cloud? I think it was called that when I met him there. I think that's the first time I met him. He was doing this like fly-in promo tour with a mutual rock star friend of ours, and I went to see them play and actually sat in on one of their songs on Lap Steel. And but boy, then John moved to Chicago and running King Size and teaching and gigging and playing and dad, and oh, you rock, John. And I don't know that I've ever encountered John in a bad mood. He's always like got wide-eyed wonder about music, whether it's him performing or recording you or teaching it. He's just a great dude. Happy birthday, John. Yeah. And Ingrid Groudens. Oh, happy birthday, Ingrid. We miss you. Yeah, Ingrid, I believe moved down to Nashville, correctly? correct? Correct me if I'm wrong. Am I wrong? I met Ingrid through Steve, like I've met so many of these beautiful people. And, she's a sweetheart of a sweetheart. She's a pretty decent singer, too. Voice of an angel. I mean, unicorn. You get her and Steve squared together and look out. We got some major harmonies going on here. And minor, too. They do it all. They do it all. Ingrid, I think I have a good idea for a duet between you and me, believe it or not. I got a good idea of a song that you and I could cover, and I think we could do a nice job on it. So let's talk. Have your people call my people, okay? What happened? I was downstairs yesterday, and I played a little clip of the thing I had recorded yesterday, and I heard it back on speakers that I don't normally listen on. And it reminded me of like the first times I heard my voice on a cassette recorder or a boombox as a kid played back, right? And then the first time I tried writing songs and like recording them and hearing my voice back, just, you know, unsteady and unsure and, you know, didn't know how to breathe and sing. Arguably still don't. But I think that may be like a universal, I was almost going to say self-loathing, but it's just this, I think most people I've ever talked to about this, like, can't stand the sound of their own voice when they hear it played back. I don't know. Maybe I'm completely projecting that onto other people, but, it's only been in the recent, you know, in recent years that I can, you know, record something and listen back to it over and over if I'm working on it and like not be, you know, feel okay about, you know, what my voice sounds like. But yesterday it just sounded like a nasal teenager. I need the low stuff. But then that got me thinking. It reminded me of, you know, I do all this work on the Studs Terkel archive, and I listen to I listen to so many of his interviews. And a lot of times he'll recount what he used to do early on. You know, he used to go around, he'd travel with this thing. He had a big, you know, one of the big early, I think he had like a half-inch tape recorder, and then he might have had like one of the big portable cassette recorders. I think it was always like the quarter or half-inch. I gotta check on that. But, you know, a big thing. Sometimes he'd strap it on his shoulder when he was doing, like, you know, protests and neighborhood stuff. And but he would say that when he went to interview people, say, like, in the projects or people living in poverty, a lot of people, and oftentimes they'd have children there in the house with them, and they'd never seen a tape recorder before. And, you know, he really wanted them to be comfortable. So he would set the recorder down and just start talking, and he'd let the kids play with it. And then he'd spend a few minutes like tape recording the kids to say hello and maybe sing a song, and then play it back for them so that they could hear it and like not be afraid of that, and make them feel comfortable around him to tell their stories. And I think that was a huge part of his traction, just his empathy for people and getting them to open up. I mean, that was his whole thing, you know. He just wants everybody's story. He didn't get to everybody, but, you know, just everybody counts. We're all in this together, and everyone's got a story, and good stories. Funny ones, sad ones, tragic ones, you know. I just thought of that when I was hearing my voice back. And then I thought, one of my favorite bands as a kid, I think this guy may have been the first one that, like, I'd sing along with the record in my bedroom, right? and I think this is the first time I recognized my voice being in like a similar range to an artist that I loved. You know, I don't quite have that gravelly rumble that Richard Butler does, but the fact that I could sing along and pretty much everything he does is like right in my vocal range was a nice, I don't know, it's just very comfortable. You know, I love covering his songs, and I would show you Forever Now, but it's actually in one of those album cover frames downstairs. I love that record so much. So I'm gonna play a song that's not on any of these records. I'll play you something off the Love Spit Love record, a song I just adore. And sing out, everybody. You got beautiful voices. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise, especially yourself. All right, everybody be well. Let's go sing. Myself, and I turn my back on my faith. It's like glass when we break. I wish no one in my place. And I've seen you don't need their seeds when their dirt goes in deep. And I'm lost in sleep. I can't stay in this place. I can't stand when the room turns round on my fate. You give no guarantees. There's no promise I can keep. I can't stand, I can't see my way. I feel blind on my feet. I can't stay too long. Am I wrong? Goodbye. Goodbye, lay the blame on luck. Goodbye, lay the blame on luck. Goodbye, lay the blame on luck. I'm so tired of my moods, and sleep comes with a knife, fork, and a spoon. You're so pale in your face. You let life get in your way. And I've seen you don't need their seeds when their dirt goes in deep. And I'm lost in sleep. Am I wrong? Goodbye, lay the blame on luck. Goodbye, lay the blame on luck. Goodbye, lay the blame on luck. Goodbye. Lay the blame on Happy birthday, John and Ingrid. Love you both. Oh, be well. Stay safe and healthy and keep singing and recording and playing and teaching. I'm going to kiss him and hug him and kiss him and hug him. Be well, everybody.